हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9। प्रीवियस डे वी हैड स्टार्टेड फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ योर बुक भी है, अ ट्रूली ब्यूटीफुल माइंड रिलेटेड टू अल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन। नाउ आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग सम ऑफ द पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू स्टार्टिंग 7th पैराग्राफ। सी द चैप्टर। He also felt a special interest in a fellow student whose name was Mileva Merrick, whom he found to be a clever creature. This young serf had come to Switzerland because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. Einstein saw in her an ally against the Philistines, those people in his family and at the university with whom he was constantly at odds. The couple fell in love. Letters survive in which they put their affection into words, mixing signs with tenderness. Wrote Einstein, "How happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work on relativity to a victorious conclusion." It is written that Albert Einstein was not interested in science, but he was also interested in a fellow student whose name was Mileva Merrick and whom he thought a clever student. This Siberian young girl had come to Switzerland because at that time all the universities didn't provide education to women, and this university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. That's why she had come there. Einstein saw in her an ally, ally friends or associate against the Philistine. Philistine is a word used disapprovingly to talk about people whom do not like art, literature or music. These people are called Philistines. Those people in his family and at the university with whom he was constantly at odds. He didn't match with such students. Albert Einstein and Mileva, the couple, fell in love. They started sending letters in which they used to put their affection into words. They used to mix signs with tenderness. Once Albert Einstein wrote to Mileva, "How happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work to relativity to a victorious conclusion, when we would reach to our conclusion." In 1900, at the age of 21, Albert Einstein was a university graduate and unemployed. He worked as a teaching assistant, gave private lessons, and finally secured a job in 1902 as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. While he was supposed to be assessing other people's inventions, Einstein was actually developing his own ideas in secret. He is said to have jokingly called his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. In this paragraph, it is written that when Albert Einstein became 21 years old in 1900, he was a university graduate but unemployed. He started his work as a teaching assistant. He also gave private lessons, and finally he got a job in 1902 as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. You must know the name of patent, the meaning of patent. Patent, whenever any person invents anything, they want to register it by their name. Patent is a document which gives the right of an invention to an inventor. Otherwise, other people would claim that it is his invention. That's why people used to do patent after any invention, whenever they used to invent anything. So he got a job in 1902 as a technical expert in patents office in Bern. When he was doing his work, actually he was also developing his own ideas in secret. He had kept several inventions in his desk drawer. That's why he used to call his desk drawer the Bureau of Theoretical Physics, because all the inventions throughout the world used to come to Albert Einstein for registration, for patent. One of the famous papers of 1905 was Einstein's special theory of relativity, according to which time and distance are not absolute. Indeed, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after a journey. If one of them has been moving very fast relative to the others. From this followed the world's most famous formula, which describes the relationship between mass and energy, which is called E barabar mc square. In 1905, Einstein wrote a special theory of relativity, according to which he said that time and distance are not absolute. If we put two perfectly accurate clocks, it will not show the same time if they come together again after a journey, if one of them has been moving very fast and other is kept in a static position. And from this followed the world's most famous formula. You must have heard the name of this formula, E barabar mc square. In this mathematical equation, E stands for energy, m for mass, and c for speed of light in the vacuum, about 3 lakh kilometers per second. It is said that when you sit with a nice girl for 2 hours, you feel that you have spent only 2 minutes. But when you sit on a hot stove for 2 minutes, it seems like 2 hours. That is relativity. Whenever we wait for someone, we think that we have spent enough time. While Einstein was solving the most difficult problem in physics, his private life was unraveling. Albert had wanted to marry Mileva right after finishing his studies, but his mother was against it. She thought Mileva, who was 3 years older than her son, was too old for him. She was also bothered by Mileva's intelligence. "She is a book like you," his mother said. That's why Einstein put the wedding off. When Einstein was engaged to solve the world's most difficult problem in physics, his private life was starting to fall, because Albert Einstein wanted to marry Mileva just after completing his studies. But his mother was against this marriage. She thought Mileva was 3 years older than her son. She thought that she was too old for her son. She was also bothered by Mileva's intelligence. "She is book like you," she used to say. His mother said. That's why Einstein put the wedding off. He left the idea. The pair finally married in January 1903 and had 2 sons. But a few years later, the marriage faltered. Mileva, meanwhile, was losing her intellectual ambition and becoming an unhappy housewife. After years of constant fighting, the couple finally divorced in 1990. Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. although the pair finally married in January 1903, and they had two sons. But after some years, the marriage became so weak because Mileva thought that she was losing her intellectual ambition and she had become an unhappy housewife. That's why after years of constant fighting, Mileva and Einstein finally divorced in 1919. But Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. We have started 11th paragraph and rest of the paragraph will be completed later. Thanking all of you. Have a nice day.